Old friends and even older enemies are complicating the life of Peter Parker. What'll happen next? Well, let's hop on into The Amazing Spider-Man issue number 1 and find out for ourselves, shall we? Alrighty then, so this issue actually picks up from where the Free Comic Book Day issue left off. Didn't read it, that's okay, I covered them right here. All you really need to know is that Peter Parker is living in the city again, only with rising real estate prices, now he needs not one, but two roommates. First is a lifelong friend of his, Randy Robertson, son of Robbie, his boss. And get this, Fred Myers, aka the D-list suited villain known as Boomerang, the leader of the superior foes of Spider-Man. And wouldn't you know it, on top of being a loser villain, this guy also happens to be a loser roommate, playing Call of Duty at 5 in the morning, never refilling the Brita. Spider-Man would love to kick his ass, but he can't for a couple reasons. One, to do so might very well jeopardize his own identity as Peter Parker. They also really need the money. And having him live under the same roof as Spider-Man means the webhead can actually keep tabs on this guy and his gang's movement. This, as we just discover, is one of many snags happening in the life of Peter Parker Spider-Man. The next comes in the form of Mayor Wilson Fisk, the Kingpin, who rose to power in the Daredevil book, in case you weren't aware. Fisk ambushes Spider-Man, but not to hurt him, quite the opposite. He wants to give him the key to the city. Why would he want to do something so nice for someone who is running a zero-tolerance policy on superheroes in New York? Well, you see, the Kingpin knows how desperately Spider-Man wants to be liked by everyone else, and he figures by honoring him and hunting all the other heroes, he can drive a major wedge between them all. Wow, getting heroes not to like each other and not starting a civil war? What restraint. This means when Spider-Man attempts to step on in and help the Avengers with an alien invasion, they all give him the cold shoulder like he ran over their dog. And I mean, for guys like Johnny Storm to give the cold shoulder, that's pretty damn impressive. But hey, that's just the spandex life. What's beating up on Peter Parker's personal life? Well, you see, as part of his job as tech editor for the Daily Bugle, Pete gets called in to see a conference hosted by one of his old classmates from Empire University. You see, this lady has developed state-of-the-art software that's able to pick out plagiarized paper. She tries to use Peter Parker as an example and ends up actually pinging him for a doctorate paper written by Dr. Octopus while in Peter's body. This means until Peter can prove he's not a cheater or redo the work, all of his academic achievements for the last little bit have just been rendered null and void. This is overall a pretty crazy situation. No one would believe him if he tried to tell the truth. The only person that Pete can confide in is Mary Jane. After all, she's been through the craziness with him. This revelation actually ends up having a hell of a ripple effect. Robbie ends up having to let Peter go, half because of the bad press it brings to the paper, but also because, well, no one reads newspapers anymore. Pete's so embarrassed he even tries to hide the truth from Aunt May, only to get a very serious talking to about how it seems like he's been shirking his responsibilities lately. Ooh, ouch. But here's the crazy thing, Peter actually takes this conversation to heart and he thinks that his aunt is right. It was wrong for him to ride on the academic achievements of someone else, especially because when he believes that if he did put his mind to it, he could have written a better paper than Otto. And hey, speaking of putting one's mind to the test, it's because of all of this Peter is able to suss out that this alien invasion is actually one giant illusion perpetrated by Mysterio. Hey, would you look at that, everybody? Quentin Beck is back in town and just in time for his new movie appearance too, ain't that something? Peter is a hero again, but everything that's been happening to him, all the licks he's been taking, has made him stop and reevaluate his life, what's most important to him, and who's the person he went to when all the chips were down. That person is again, well, Mary Jane, to which Peter says, I love you, I've always loved you, and she responds that, yeah, I've always loved you too, we've always been in it together, let's get back together. And you hear that sound, everyone? That's the sound of 10 years worth of Spider-Man fans all breathing one giant sigh of relief all together as one. And that's where the comic ends, everyone. That was Amazing Spider-Man number 1, and I gotta say, Nick Spencer gets his run off to a pretty good start. There's a lot of new and a lot of old all kind of mixed together in one for a nice little comic cocktail. Come this time next week, everyone will still be raving about the Mary Jane relationship rekindling, and they should. It's something people have wanted for a long time, and it's nice to see Marvel finally give it back to them, even if it's just a little bit at a time. But, you know, I don't think we should also look over a lot of the other stuff this book gets right, mainly that Spencer continues to be one of the most genuinely funny people writing comics today, or that Ottilie puts in maybe some of the very best artwork of his career. I would say this book in many ways is the perfect storm of factors, and I hope it has a long, prosperous run. Overall, I would give it a very strong 8 out of 10.
Hey there, everyone. It's your old pal Cape Joel again, thanking you so much for watching to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, why not check out some more content from my channel. Then you can follow me on Twitter and Facebook at Cabe Joel, so you're always up to speed on what I got coming out next. And hey, if you really like what I do, you could become a patron. Patrons get exclusive access to videos and content before anyone else, and they can do so for as little as $1 a month. And with that, everyone, I will bid you adieu, and I will be back again with more comic content that smacks of greatness. Bye-bye, everyone.